One of 22 strategic water sources areas that make up 10% of our land but provide 50% of our water.
The journey started in the small town of Greyton in the Overberg region. And this year's walkers quickly became part of nature by crossing the Gobbos River, a tributary of the Rivier Sonder End. The Gobbos is overgrown with alien invasive trees. As a result, less water reaches the Rivier Sonder End River and in turn the Teerwaterskloof Dam, which Cape Town so badly depends upon.
All the large trees behind me are mostly invasive alien plants. I mean, there's a number of species behind me, but they all shouldn't be there. Invasive plants are a major problem. The biggest problem is they use much more water than our indigenous plants. But also the problem that, as I now stated, they cause the banks to collapse. And so that's a secondary problem with invasive, not only the water use.
Once the aliens have invaded the river system, they have to be removed. And once removed, there is very little left in and around our rivers, which affects water quality and quantity. So the river systems need to be restored.
This is Khanet and our community nursery, where we propagate our indigenous plants for the alien clearing and restoration project in Rivier Sonder End. So we employed local communities from Khanet and Dao and Greyton. So we have 19 people that are working here, growing indigenous plants that we plant them in our rivers, local rivers and Rivier Sonder End main river.
And tell me about this plant that we've got here and what role it plays.
This is one of our indigenous plants. It's called Vigilia, and it helps the river banks. It holds the soil and stabilizes the river banks to protect the erosion. If we do restoration after the alien clearing, it helps to protect and suppress the regrowth of alien invasive plants.
Even a short stretch of river that is rehabilitated and restored makes a huge difference downstream.
So we're standing on the Mille Rivier Bridge, and it'd be hard to believe that actually what was behind me, all you could see was just rubble, just rocks, in 2016. And this is a really great example of where we've gone from alien plant clearing, but sometimes when you clear, it's just, there's nothing left behind. And it's actually necessary to do what we call active restoration, where you go and get the plants like you saw grown at the nursery and bring them and actually plant them into the areas that you've cleared. And this here, what they're doing, what plants are doing, is providing a really important function of supporting the bridge. So engineers came to us, they'd fixed the bridge after a big flood event, and then we're going, actually, this is not enough. We need some natural infrastructure. So you're having the actual plants being put back to make a healthier system. And that's what's been achieved here. And if you look into the river, you'll see some really important plants like palmeet that are slowing down the river's pace as it comes through underneath this bridge. So a fantastic example of why both built infrastructure and natural infrastructure work together, why it's so necessary to have restoration.
Once the clearing and restoration has been done in a river, continued follow-up clearing needs to take place. This is to ensure that the alien invasive species do not take over again, spread and choke out indigenous vegetation. These dedicated teams of people are battling this never-ending cycle of clearing and restoring our rivers to ensure that the water of rivers like the Rivier Sonder End eventually end up in our taps. Linky Beerman, SABC News, Cape Town.